Hello. Just got a Logitech digi camera today in the mail, and pretty excited. It comes with these handy avatars, and I couldn't resist you using this one. Raptor Jesus with the Dianetics volcano in the background. I wanted to play with the camera, but I also wanted to share with you a blog that I found while going about my business and reading things online. Anyway, this particular blog is askthescientologist.blogspot.com, and it's quite interesting. And one of the articles that I read most recently, it was posted on August 5th, 2008, is Scientologists, Masters of Doublethink. And he quotes George Orwell from 1984, Doublethink. The power of holding two contradictory beliefs in one's mind simultaneously and accepting both of them, to tell deliberate lies while genuinely believing in them, to forget any fact that has become inconvenient, and then when it becomes necessary again, to draw it back from oblivion for just so long as it is needed, to deny the existence of objective reality, and all the while to take account of the reality which one denies. All of this is indispensably necessary. Even in using the word doublethink, it is necessary to exercise doublethink, for by using the word, one admits that one is tampering with reality. By a fresh act of doublethink, one erases this knowledge, and so on indefinitely, with the lie always one leap ahead of the truth. End quote. Interesting. Now, in short, doublethink is the carefully cultured, self-controlled skill of being able to know and completely accept two contradictory facts. Perhaps everyone does this a little bit. A few examples the author gave says, first, one, the OT3 materials. We'll start with that. It's particularly apropos with the volcano in the background. The OT3 materials are operating Theta-3 materials. That's the Xenu story. You know it. I know it. Millions of people know it. Now, on the one hand, Scientologists know that the OT3 materials are deadly. They know that just reading the OT3 materials before one is ready will kill a person, or at least give them pneumonia. They know this with absolute certainty. And conversely, on the other hand, Scientologists also know that the OT3 materials have been leaked. Secret materials were published in court documents, newspapers, magazines. They were explained in detail in South Park, which has a huge fan base. These OT3 materials are all over the internet. This is the primary reason Scientologists cannot look at newspapers, books, the internet, etc. Because they might find out these materials before the church has a chance to charge them for it, perhaps. Scientologists also know that millions and millions of people have read these materials and there were no harmful effects. No mass genocide caused by leakage of OT materials online. And no mass deaths reported after the South Park episode aired, any of the times it aired. Go figure. So they know both of these contradictory things are absolutely true. And I'm using the word no in kind of a sarcastic sense here. Alright, so let's go to cognitive dissonance situation number two. Scientologists know, without a shadow of a doubt, that Scientology is the fastest growing religion in the world, and they know that the church is always seeing unprecedented expansion worldwide. That's according to Scientologists. They know that the church is always. They know this. They know it's true because they're told that. On the other hand, when they look at reality, Scientologists also know, outside of David Miscavige's flamboyant events and press statements, they don't see or hear anything about this expansion, and they're always being asked for more and more money to help with this expansion that they don't see. Scientologists are aware that their local church is not expanding. They're aware that fewer Scientologists show up at their events. They're aware that the church's course rooms are nearly empty week after week. Alright, well, how can you know both of these contradictory things? It's very strange. Scientologists believe in this vast, incredible expansion of their churches, and at the same time they see with their very own eyes the reality, which is only deterioration, falling numbers. Go figure. Alright, situation number three. On the one hand, Scientologists know all Scientologists are masters of communication. They know that through the various Scientology communication courses they know more about and are better communication than anyone else. On the other hand, when they get out in the real world, Scientologists are also aware that they cannot talk to certain types of people. The majority of the people in the world are people whom, as Scientologists, cannot talk to. Anyone who disagrees with Scientology is not to be communicated with. Reporters, psychologists, psychiatrists, anonymous, critics, anyone who doesn't accept immediately Scientologist doctrines must be avoided. And that includes a Scientologist's best friends, their spouses, their family members, their co-workers. Anybody who doesn't get along with the Scientology doctrines must be discommunicated from and not communicated to. So, disconnected from and not communicated to, pardon me. Very strange dichotomy there. Scientologists know that Scientology quote-unquote works. They know Scientology is the effective solution to all the world's ills. On the other hand, Scientologists are not completely stupid. They see other Scientologists behaving badly, not repaying loans, running less than reputable companies. They hear rumors about other Scientologists raping underage girls. They hear rumors about the private investigators. They see their fellow members behaving, you know, showing their asses when out in the public. They get in trouble with the law. They are thrown in jail. So Scientologists are seeing all this, and they're quite often struggling to survive themselves. Scientologists see their local church struggling, barely making it from week to week. They've heard of all these various world trouble spots, and Miscavige says they're being handled at each one of these events, and yet those trouble spots are still there, and they're not being handled. So they... How is Scientology working? Tell me this. So, despite all the effective solutions, quote-unquote, of Scientology, all that Scientologists see for themselves and other Scientologists, outside of the alleged successes of Miscavige's fantastical events, is struggle and failure. How disheartening. And lastly, Scientologists know that people who have completed OT-8 are virtually godlike. They are far, far above everyone else on the planet with their powers and abilities beyond our comprehension. You know, the whole being able to affect and control matter, energy, space, and time, M-E-S-T, MEST. And then these Scientologists, if they have the honor to meet an OT-8, they notice that these OT-8s are, shall we say, rather ordinary? Why, yes. Let's say they're ordinary. They do not see any OT-8 special abilities. They do not see OT-8s behaving any differently from anyone else. They don't see OT-8s behaving any differently than they did before all those levels. The evidence that they see is that nothing special happened. The ultimate accomplishment in Scientology is OT-8, at least until Miscavige spoils the tech some more and releases OT-9 and 10. But right now, OT-8 is all that you can buy. Know this. So Scientologists accept these all-too-normal OT-8s while believing that OT-8 will give them godlike perceptions and powers. There are very many, many other contrary facts that Scientologists must be able to hold on to in their little heads while continuing to believe in Scientology. Doublethink is an essential skill for Scientologists. It's ironic that L. Ron Hubbard himself once wrote in Ability magazine, this is from 1961, "What is true for you, this is personal integrity, what is true for you is what you've observed yourself, and when you lose that, you've lost everything. What is personal integrity? Personal integrity is knowing what you know is what you know, and to have the courage to know and say what you have observed. And that is integrity, and there is no other integrity." That's L. Ron, that's Source. So what's deeply ironic about all this is Scientologists who remain loyal, true believers in Scientology have had to abandon their personal integrity. They've had to abandon their ability to accept what is really there. They've had to abandon their ability to know what is just plain fucking obvious. My God! Ultimately, for Scientologists, what is true for them is not what they observe for themselves. What is true is only what the Church of Scientology tells them to believe. Now, paraphrased from this blog, askthescientologist.blogspot.com. These guys are brilliant. I'm enjoying it. They're intelligent. They're articulate. I hope you'll check them out. And thank you for indulging me while I play with Raptor Jesus and the exploding volcano in the background. It's been a pleasure to make this video for you.